Good morning, PCEP. I'm Audrey.
And I'm Olivia.
And we're here with your morning announcements.
You know you love laughing, but when was the last time you laughed at an improv show put on by your very own classmates? The answer is a little over 2 years, because the first improv show since 2019 is happening Wednesday, May 25th at 7 p.m. Come to the Du Bois Little Theater and see an amazing series of scenes made up on the spot for free. In ordinance with Mrs. Merritt's recent announcement, masks are strongly recommended for those watching the show.
A PCEP job fair is being held at Canton High School this Wednesday, 9 a.m. to 1 p.m., hosted by PCEP's CTE department. Students age 16 and up can come and meet with local employers from automotive industry, machining, manufacturing, military, and other business with exciting job opportunities for students. Students should bring a resume with them. For those interested in attending, please complete the registration form available in link from counseling offices.
This Thursday on May 26th during fifth hour, Northern Michigan University will be at the Career Center at Canton, room 127. Please register if you'd like to attend.
Distribution of the PCEP 21-22 yearbook will be today through Thursday during all lunches at Plymouth in room 401 off the cafeteria. If you pre-ordered a yearbook, please print and complete the yearbook pickup form that was sent via email from the publisher. Limited copies of the yearbook can be purchased for $100 cash only during lunch distribution.
Mr. Walker's third hour is holding a toiletry drive for the Samaritas Shelter in Westland. At Salem, items can be dropped off in room 2208 in Ms. Cummings, at Plymouth, Ms. Maturin's in 215C, and at Canton, Ms. Wysocki in room 151. All standard items like shampoo, toothpaste, toothbrushes, and body wash are welcome.
Now here are some announcements especially for seniors. Class of 2022, have you sent in your money and form to attend this year's senior party? The event takes place on June 16th from 3:30 to 9 at the varsity field. Your $50 ticket gets you unlimited food, a t-shirt, games, and tons of fun. Activities include a DJ, caricature artists, hypnotist show, knockerball, henna tattoos, a donut wall, and more. Every graduating senior who attends will leave with a prize. Forms are in all the school's offices. Don't miss this opportunity to spend time with your class of 2022 one last time. If you are 17, you must have a parent's signature to purchase your ticket. Get your order form today.
Attention all PCEP seniors. This is the last week to purchase prom tickets at all three lunches from May 23rd to 26th. You must have a completed prom agreement with either cash or check made out to PCCS. Any questions, please see Ms. Kennison or Ms. Maples in Canton, Ms. Voss in Plymouth, or Mrs. Smith or Mr. Rucci in Salem.
Did you know that 79% of Americans 65 and older voted in the last elections in the U.S. and only 51% of Americans that are in the age group 18-25 voted? If you are interested in changing these statistics, come register to vote during all lunches at Salem while prom tickets are being sold until May 27th. Make sure to bring your driver's license or the last four digits of your social security number to register. Voting is the best way to get involved in our democracy.
That's all for your announcements, PCEP. Have a great Tuesday.
Good morning, PCEP. I'm Bradley here with your weather. Today will be a high of 71 and a low of 52 and partly cloudy. That's all for your weather, PCEP. Have a great day.
What's up, PCEP? It's Caleb here with the news bit. Last week, the endangered California condor returned to soar the skies over California's redwood forest for the first time in more than a century. Condors were last spotted in the park area around 1892. Authorities said the California condor is the largest native North American bird with a wingspan of nearly 10 feet. And here's two people to show the scale of that. The birds can live for 60 years and fly vast distances in search of carrion, so their range could extend into several states. The scavenging bird, which feeds on dead animals, was once widespread but had virtually disappeared by the 1970s because of poaching. Lead poisoning from eating animals shot by hunters and destruction of its habitat. In the early 1980s, in an aggressive species preservation move, all 22 condors remaining in the wild were trapped and brought into a captive breeding program that began releasing the giant vultures into Southern California's Los Padres National Forest in 1992. That flock has been expanding its range while other condors now occupy parts of California's Central Coast, Arizona, Utah, and Baja California, Mexico. The total population now numbers more than 500 birds in captivity in the wild. 2 years ago, the California condors were spotted in Sequoia National Park in California's Sierra Nevada for the first time in nearly 50 years. Last week, two captive bred birds were released from a pen in the Redwood National Park about an hour drive south of the Oregon border. under a project aimed at restoring the giant vultures to their historic habitat in the Pacific Northwest. The two male condors were moved into a staging area at late morning, and a remotely controlled gate was opened. After a few minutes of warily eyeing the open, the birds stepped one by one through the opening, spread their giant wings, and took off. This is now the first time in over a century that the birds will be in this part of California.
Hey PCEP, it's Ella here with your sports. Last night, the Tigers lost 5-4 to the Twins. However, they came back from a 4-0 deficit in the ninth. Some bad news for Tigers fans. All five of our starting pitchers are now on the injured list. Yep, you heard that right, all five. This was the Tigers scrambling to find new starting pitchers to bring up from the minors. Early on in the season, Casey Mize and Matt Manning were put on the shelf with injuries. While they were both working through rehab assignments, it was a wrench in the rotation early on in the season. In the game against the Rays on Wednesday, Eduardo Rodriguez had to leave the game early. He would record just one out before exiting the game and turning things over to the bullpen. After that, Michael Pineda sustained a finger injury and found himself on the IL as well. Finally, on Friday, Tarik Skubal left the game early with a contusion after a 100.4 mile per hour fastball drilled him in the shin. Last night, the Boston Celtics beat the Miami Heat 102-82. The series is now tied 2-2. Tonight, the Warriors play the Mavericks at 9. That's all for the Sports PCEP. Have a great day.
We're just getting started. We've played in 4 tournaments, and including the KLAA pre. So we have a pre-18 and a post-18, and we finished in 3rd, and we're 5 strokes out of 1st, and it's a 2-day event. So that gives us something to shoot for. Today's our first 9-hole match against Canton, and all the teams in our division are all very close, within a few strokes of each other, depending on the day. So. Really like my group. We have 11 returning guys, 8 seniors. Really excited about this season.
This time.